Hello and welcome back. In the previous tutorial, we used the web GUI of the BAM tool to define the incoming data as well as the reports to generate. Now we are ready to start integrating the BAM into our composite service. And that's done with this BAM adapter, which you drop into this exposed services lane. Give it some good name, this service. Then we need to discover the objects through this way. Actually, I don't think you see this BAM server connection, so I will delete that BAM connection to show exactly what you should be seeing in your screen. Maybe it's a little bit easier. So drag and drop this BAM adapter. Give it a service name. And say browse, we want to interactively discover what data objects are defined in the BAM path. By definition, there is no connection from JDeveloper into the running BAM server, so we need to create a BAM connection. With the machine where it's running, username, password, default port is 9001. We can test if we type the username and password correctly and say finish. And then we can interactively go and find out the objects which are defined in the BAM. Then I can define the operations, insert, update, or it's I want to use this upsert operation, which is a way of saying that insert if this record is not there already and update if it's already, so overwrite. And then I need to define this primary key, which I want to use this invoice number. I want to say enable batching, so if the BAM is not running for some reason, I think this would still run, this composite service would run and internally queue the messages. Then I need to find out what is the JNDR name, that I can do from this WebLogic server. Okay, now it takes some time because I think I restarted WebLogic server at some point. But this kind of finding out what is the right JNDR name is done similarly to what we have been doing for JMS connections. For if you go to this deployments bar there, this connections and out into deployments we go on there, from there connections and outbound connection pools, and we should find out what is the right JNDR name. It's almost certainly what is presented here, but just to be secure, let's go and check it. Okay, let's log in. Go to deployments. And then we need to go to this Oracle BAM adapter. configuration, hotbar connection pools. And we actually want to use this RMI connection factor. So this is the correct CMDN name, and just then check that this you have all the fields. You might have that this host name and password and port numbers are empty. So in that case, you need to add the data here, and you add it so that you click on here, you type in here what you want, then you press enter. It doesn't save it otherwise, then you press save. And finally, after this one, you still need to redeploy this Oracle VAM adapter once more that these changes take effect. So it might be that you have these, you only have this ADC server one, which is the correct string, but you might have these other fields as an empty. Let's go back to deployments. And then click this guy. Go up, say update. Next. And finish. And while it's deploying, we can go back to JDeveloper. I think this was correct. And now we have finished here. We can wire this guy up. And we can go back to this guy still deploying. Let's go back here and let's do the changes into the detail process. So what we want to do is that at the end we want to invoke, we want to send stuff into BAM. Let's wire these up, so invoke, send to BAM. We need a variable. Say OK. We need to do an assignment. It's a little bit bigger, so we want to populate this guy. And most of the stuff is coming from this input variable. So we want to take, for example, this invoice number. And I think there was some stuff from this validation data, like validated. Validation text. Charged amount was here. Vendor name is in this vendor fragment. And what is still missing is this validation type. So we need to create a new global variable into this people process and assign values to that one. So that's fairly easy to do. So let's just add a new variable here. Let's call this, for example, validation type. That's a string variable. And then we still need to set this string variable. So if we are in this automated part, we can add a new assignment operation. Or we could actually do the same here, but maybe it's easier. For learning purposes, it's easy if they are separate stuff. We want to take, say, for example, that this validation type is been automatic in this branch. And if we have been going through this human workflow parts, then we want to say that hyvä, että puhut tiskaa ja sitten näin vaan. Let's double check that it's in the right branch. Yes, it's in this sequence of the manual part. And then we still need to use that variable here. So let's want to put this validation type there. And that's it. So let's check that this deployment is okay. We have done all the changes in Beeple and in this composite. We are ready to deploy, and then the next part is just testing. So deploy. Alright, so now we have integrated from our composite to BAM, and in the next tutorial we will do some testing. So thanks for watching and see you in the next tutorial.